Hi nerds, hi yogis, Carlene Rose here, and welcome to a Nerdy Yogi YouTube channel. Today we'll be doing a quick twisted yoga flow. So we're going to start in our easy seat, right foot in front of the other. We don't want cross legs, stacked legs, anything like that. We'll just come into an easy seat with right leg in front and inhale. We'll do a little arch in the spine. Exhale, squeeze all of the air in and out. Inhale, expand your low belly, everything warms and wide. Exhale, lifting in and up. Inhale here. Exhale. Awesome, we're gonna take our right leg in front of our left. So right foot's kind of in front of the left knee here. We'll start with our first twist. Inhale, left arm reaches up. Now from here, we're gonna twist and just grip onto the right knee with our left elbow. Now the important thing is here is you want the twist to come from your abdominal strength. You don't want to be yanking your back with your arm to do the twist, and then if you were to let go of the leg, you spring back forward. So obviously that was very exaggerated, but hopefully you get the point. So inhale, long spine first, exhale the twist, and then grab onto the right knee. You can squeeze the right knee in a little bit closer if you want to get more of a stretch in the hips. And right arm can just come behind you. Look over the right shoulder to complete the twist. And then switch legs. So back to our easy seat, this time left foot in front. Inhale, little arch, mini back bend in the spine. Exhale. Inhale here. Exhale, really getting that breath moving, using our Ujjayi or victorious breath, so exhaling through the nose. And now right knee comes a little more forward as left foot comes to the outside of the right leg. Remember, inhale here, first long spine, then twist, and then as you have the twist, hook onto the left leg. You can even wave the spine up tall again once you're in the twist. And then left arm just gently places behind you. It's not twisting you more. It's just resting wherever it is. And then you can look over the left shoulder. And you can squeeze your left knee a little bit into your chest to get more of a stretch on the hips. Awesome. Back to center. Do some one hip twists, get some abdominal work in real quick. So start fingertips behind you. Those are good to support you here. Make sure you have a long spine. So inhale, legs extend in front of you. You'll roll onto your right hip and exhale, twist over the hip. Very perfectly named. And then other way. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. You can take these at your own pace. Go a little slower, faster, whatever's easiest for you. You can always try it with your hands lifted. I like having the support there. Just a nice reminder to keep your spine long as you're doing this. And last one, each side. Perfect, you can come to center. Here we'll sit in our butterfly or goddess pose and inhale. Stretch, exhale, rounding out the spine, inhale, stretch, exhale, one more time, we'll inhale, do some cat-cows in this pose, and then we can walk out gently, just find that first edge of stretch in this fold. So from there, walk yourself back up and make your way into your downward facing dog, however you need to get there. Make sure that you're really grounding into the earth with your fingertips, coming onto the palms, very little weight on the heel of the palm. And you can start by pedaling out your feet. So we'll do one sequence on each side. It's not a super long practice today, but we'll start bending everything, getting close to the earth, waving yourself forward into your plank, coming onto your knees, lowering through your chaturanga. Inhale here, prepare, long spine. Exhale, rolling in up. And exhale, back to your down dog. Awesome. From here, we'll bend, get close to the earth just a little bit. Inhale, lift the right leg to the sky. You will exhale, bring your right leg to the upper outside of the right arm. Inhale up. Exhale, twist right arm to the left, or right leg to the left arm. Inhale back up. Exhale for core plank to the center. But this time, come onto the pinky toe edge of your left foot and step your right foot up about halfway onto your mat. So you're at about a 90 degree angle on that right leg, and lift the right arm to the sky. You'll inhale here and exhale. We'll do some circling with the arm. Stretching out the hip as we are getting rid of any tension in our shoulders. Make your way back to down dog. And from here, twist both of your knees to the right. Bend for a twisted dog. Awesome. Holding that twist for another breath. And from there, you can stretch out into a side plank and reach right arm to the sky, really lifting up through the hips. If you need to, you can place that right foot in front of you again. Exhale, back to down dog. Awesome, lift the right leg to the sky again. Exhale, this time come all the way through, stepping the right foot to the right thumb. Inhale here, prepare. Exhale, bending the back knee, rolling yourself in and up to high lunge. Woo, awesome, feeling the work already. So from here, we're gonna do some fists of fire lunges, but we're gonna lift our back leg. So really ground into the earth with your right foot. Inhale here, prepare. Exhale, bring fists of fire and left knee lifts up. Inhale here. Exhale, really grounding into the earth, lifting up through your strong core. Inhale back last time, and exhale. Woo, awesome job. Now place your left foot down next to your right. We'll come into mountain pose, so feet are about hip distance apart. Inhale up. This time we're going to exhale into our chair, but we're going to twist it. So left elbow comes to right knee. Just holding this twist. It's not really on the knee, it's more above the knee, on the leg. Holding twist here. Now again, really ground into the earth with your right foot. Super challenge here. See if you can lift the left leg, lift higher from the core, and step the left foot back into a twisting lunge. Ooh, fantastic job. Hold that if you can for another breath. Exhale, just the left hand comes to the earth, right arm extends to the sky, and we're gonna exhale, bending closer to the earth. And as you straighten out, you can straighten out that right leg to that first edge of stretch. Exhale, circling down. Coming back into a revolved triangle pose. One last time, circle down. And hold the stretch for a moment. You can even wrap your top arm around the back if you want. Whew, you're a rock star. Bend the front leg, step back into plank, come onto your knees, lower through your chaturanga. Inhale here, prepare, roll in and up, and make your way back to down dog. And then for a moment, we're just gonna come sit on our heels, shake out our wrists. You can do some forearm massage and wrist circles, get some traction there. Find your breath if it's gone anywhere in that challenging flow. And we will do it again on the other side. So from here, grounding into the earth with your fingertips, make your way back into down dog. From here, gonna inhale, prepare, bending everything close to the earth, wave yourself forward to plank, coming onto your knees, lower through your chaturanga, inhale, long spine, roll in and up to cobra. You can come to up dog and back through pointed plank to your downward dog. And from here, we'll bend in the earth as you lift the left leg to the sky. Exhale, you're gonna come core plank, left knee to the left arm this time. Inhale up. Exhale, twist it to the right. Inhale up. Exhale, comes to the center, but come onto the pinky toe edge of your right foot this time. Step the left foot about halfway up your mat. So now we're in this kind of funky twist, which is fun. Great hip stretch as well. Left arm comes to the sky. And circling, stretching our shoulder, getting rid of any shoulder tension. And last one here. Awesome. All right. Make your way back to your downward dog. Left leg lifts to the sky. Oh, we forgot to do side plank. So, coming into our twisted dog to the left. Sorry about that, guys. So knees come, twist to the left from your down dog. Really feeling the stretch on the left side body. And then from here, coming out long into your side plank. Left arm lifts to the sky. And again, if you want, you can step the left foot forward if that feels better, or staying in the side plank with your left foot back. But really lifting up through the hips, really pressing into the earth with your arm. And then from here, come back to down dog, left leg lifts, exhale through your core plank into your lunge. Inhale here, prepare long spine, bending the back leg, rolling yourself in and up to your high lunge. All right, see, we're already almost done with the sequence on this side. So really powering into the earth, grounding into the earth with your left foot. Exhale, fists of fire lunges as right knee comes up 90 degrees. Inhale here. Exhale. Woo, if you waver or stumble at all, yeah, it's totally fine. You're building strength, and really balance is all about coming back into the pose. Awesome. Stepping the right foot down. Inhale here, prepare. Sit into your chair, really sitting on the heels. You don't want your knees to be sticking out forward. So sitting onto your heels, and right elbow comes to left leg this time. Holding this twist for a couple of breaths, really making sure your spine is long in this position. Now as we move it, you can look at the floor, really ground into the earth with your left leg. See if you can lift that right leg, not so much from the leg, but from your core strength. So you're lifting it from a little bit higher place. And then step right foot back into your twisted lunge. Again, waving the spine, making sure you've got long spine here. And this time, right hand comes to the earth. Left arm is still up. Right hand is beneath the shoulder. Extend the left arm to the sky. And we'll do those great arm circles here. Stretching the front leg to that first edge of stretch. Getting a twisted or revolved triangle. And from here, we'll hold it a couple of breaths. You can wrap your arm around your back if that feels good to you. Perfect. Bend the left leg. Make your way back into plank. Come onto your knees and lower through your chaturanga. Inhale here, prepare. Rolling yourself in and up, and this time coming through your downward dog to a child's pose. So sit back on your feet. You can rock back and forth. You've definitely earned this moment of relaxation. You can even rest your hands behind you. Open up your shoulders. From here, we're going to make our way onto our backs. Do one last twist before coming into our Shavasana final resting pose. So from here, we'll start with bent knees, feet are on the floor, cross-legged arms. across your right leg over your left. And from here, you're going to scoot your hips just a little bit to the right so that you can drop your knees to the left for a great spinal twist, but your spine is still in really good alignment. And then from here, you can reach your arms out wide. You can put them in a V if that feels better for you. You goddess arms. Whatever stretch you're feeling like you need right now for the upper body, do that. If you want to twist a little more, you can look over the right shoulder. We'll make our way back to center. All right, so from the center position, left leg this time crosses over right. Again, scoot your hips a little bit to the left before dropping the knees to the right so you have that good spinal alignment still. Find your comfortable arm position with for whatever stretch you need. And then if you want, you can look over the left shoulder. Then we'll do kind of one last stretch here because I'm feeling it. So bring your knees to your chest. We're going to do like a reclined forward fold. So you'll bring both of your legs kind of straight to that first edge of stretch, really pressing into the air with your heels. And from here, you're going to lift your shoulders off the ground and bring your knees, or I guess bring your legs, towards your face. So whatever is comfortable, you can grab your calves, you can grab behind your hamstrings, you can hold on to your toes. We're stretching out the low back here as well as getting our legs. And then from here, after you've started opening up a little bit, you can relax your upper back onto the mat. Awesome. So take any yogi's choice stretch that you might need, then come out into your Shavasana, final resting pose. Big lion's breath, so exhale, stick out your tongue. Really roar out any oxygen that maybe got stuck while we were doing all of that moving and twisting. Twisting is so good for your digestive system, so did a lot of awesome work today. Well, I hope you enjoyed that twisting flow. Take all of that power and energy that you just created with you into the rest of your day, whatever you've got going on. Be sure that you are subscribed to the channel so you get all of the new videos and that you're on the email list. I got a lot of exclusive content for you, so make sure you're on that as well. And I look forward to seeing you on the mat again soon. Namaste.